humanity. We seem to have it all. More food than we can consume. Huge houses, cities that offer everything. But at what cost? For more than 4.5 billion years of Earth's history, there has never been a richness of life like the one we see today. Even though up to 95% of plants, animals, and microorganisms that ever existed have been destroyed by 5 mass extinctions, life has recovered and thrived in a new environment. In spite of that, this ongoing 6th mass extinction may be the most serious environmental threat to our civilization. In the last century, thousands of populations of critically endangered animal species were lost, indicating that the accelerating 6th mass extinction is, indeed, caused by human activities. The 6th extinction that we see today is part of a series that managed to wipe out over half of living creatures in the last half billion years. All told, more than 90% of organisms that have ever lived on Earth are now gone. Here are the biggest die-offs that archaeologists managed to identify in the fossil records. The most recent extinction that everybody knows about is the Cretaceous extinction. A space rock impact is the number one suspect for this event that wiped out the world's dinosaurs. Scientists believe that this huge crater in Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula is proof of this hypothesis. Although the impact was devastating, most mammals and reptiles survived, along with most sea life. With dinosaurs out of the way, mammals flourished, giving rise to our ancestors, Homo sapiens, that sparked the 6th mass extinction. So, how did we get here? As scientists have identified, during the 6th extinction, we took over the planet in two phases. Phase 1 took place when the first modern humans began to migrate to different parts of the world, about 100,000 years ago. And phase 2 started when humans turned to agriculture about 10,000 years ago. All over the world, shortly after modern humans arrived, many native species became extinct. This was because humans were damaging ecosystems through overhunting and spreading of microbial disease. Even though only around 2% of all the species that ever lived are alive today, the absolute number of species is greater now than ever before. So how is this 6th extinction different from the other ones? There is little doubt that humans are the direct cause of ecosystem destruction in the modern world through activities such as transformation of landscape, overexploitation of species and natural resources, pollution, and the introduction of invasive species. But because we don't see the effects of extinction all the time, we tend to underestimate the devastating results of losing biodiversity. Think about the consequences of extinction as burning an art gallery. So you're not even thinking about potential direct value at all, but you're thinking about the intangible loss of the world heritage. Remember, any single species is a product of millions of years of continuous evolution. You're looking at the loss of what makes humanity part of the web of life. You're looking at what makes us whole. So what can we do to stop this, or better yet, reverse it? We are in a situation that is causing unprecedented, life-threatening consequences. Business as usual is no longer possible, and changes have to be made now, because our time is quickly running out. Here are some of the best collective actions we can take in order to reverse the 6th mass extinction. Conserving what's left of biodiversity by completely stopping habitat destruction. The biggest causes of extinction are deforestation and the overexploitation of natural resources. This goes along with destruction of natural habitats and the extinction of local species. We, as individuals, can have an impact over those matters through petitions, voting for capable leaders, and taking action when we see our local habitats under threat. Rebuilding habitats by copying the natural design through permaculture. Permaculture is the opposite of extractive traditional agriculture because it provides solutions that humans need for thriving and living in harmony with nature. By practicing permaculture, we as individuals can have the biggest impact. We can create housing and food for local biodiversity while growing our own nutritional food. It's a win-win situation. So, what actions are you taking or want to take in order to reverse this 6th extinction? Let us know in the comments.